Welcome to our program this afternoon. The piece that you just heard, My Spirit Sang All Day by Gerald Finzi, is the first of five pieces with a theme of the Spirit. These pieces, while all dealing with the concept of Spirit, are from a variety of styles and historical periods. Our next selection is from Thomas Tallis, who lived in the 16th century. Following the Tallis, we will sing Bach's well-known motet from the Baroque era, Der Geist hilft unserer Schwachheit auf, The Spirit Helps Us in Our Weakness. The piece after that, Gracious Spirit, Dwell With Me, is Kay Lee Scott's beautiful setting of Thomas Aquinas' 13th century hymn, Adoro Te Devote. The first line of the original Latin text translates, I devoutly adore you, hidden deity. And we will end the group of spirit songs with Moses Hogan's lively spiritual, I'm Gonna Sing Till the Spirit Moves in My Heart. We hope you enjoy Songs of the Spirit. The first two pieces that the Augustana Choir will sing today are settings of Latin texts. The first, Gloria Patri, starts with a very rhythmic setting of the traditional Latin Gloria Patri text by the young Indonesian composer Budi Susanto Johannes. The second work by the Norwegian composer Ola Yelo is a setting of Ubi Caritas, a text that will introduce the theme of love and community, which is the emphasis of the rest of the program by the Augustana Choir. We hope you enjoy Gloria Patri and Ubi Caritas.
Gloria, 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 Glo
These next two works deal with a theme that is an important part of American society, the story of immigrants and the story of the Statue of Liberty. Sandra Choi and Caroline Shaw, two of America's current crop of influential young composers, chose to compose works based on the text of Emma Lazarus' poem, The New Colossus, which is cast on a bronze plaque mounted inside the lower level of the Statue of Liberty. The full poem reads, "Not like the brazen giant of Greek fame, with conquering limbs astride from land to land, here at our sea-washed sunset gates shall stand a mighty woman with a torch, whose flame is the imprisoned lightning, and her name, Mother of Exiles. From her beacon hand glows worldwide welcome. Her mild eyes command the air-bridged harbor that twin cities frame. Keep, ancient lands, your storied pomp, cries she with silent lips. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. Send these, the homeless, tempest-tossed, to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door." Both of these composers have taken parts of this poem and set them to music that reflects the intensity and truth of what it means to be a society that welcomes the tired, the poor, and the huddled masses yearning to breathe free.
Give me your tired, 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 tired. Give me your tired, tired, give me, give me.
The final work on this part of the concert is a setting of a poem by Daniel Ledinsky called The Sun Never Says. While there is some controversy surrounding this poem regarding its origin, some have said that Ledinsky made a translation of the Persian poet Hafez. It is, however, not completely clear whether the poem is a translation, or as Ledinsky, an American Sufi poet, has said, he has heard the poems from Hafez himself in a dream. I feel my relationship to Hafez defies all reason. He says in the book's introduction, it is really an attempt to do the impossible, to translate light into words. While we may never know the true origin of the poem, there is a simplicity and beauty to the words, which also relates to the acceptance of all people, as described in Emma Lazarus' wonderful poetry. The poem reads, "Even after all this time, the sun never says to the earth, 'You owe me.' Look what happens with a love like that. It lights the whole sky."
After all this time,
Our final section of the concert this afternoon will be three movements from Giuseppe Verdi's Requiem Mass. This coming spring, in the first weekend of March, this group of singers, along with members of the Augustana Oratorio Society, will perform the entire Requiem Mass with the Quad City Symphony Orchestra. Today, you will get a little taste of the feast to come, which reminds me that you are invited to a reception downstairs in the fellowship hall following the concert. Okay, so you can head down that direction for a fellowship for a little after feast. And any Augustana alumni are welcome to join us just outside in the back here near the parking lot to sing By the Mighty Mississippi immediately following the concert, even before the reception. I would like to say a special word of thanks to our orchestra today, Sheila Doak. who is filling in for the full orchestra on the piano. And in addition, I would like to welcome our special guest, Karen Wolverton, right here, who is joining us from the Minneapolis area, along with other members of the solo quartet, who are members of Augustana Choral Artists, Maureen Holmes, Ben Holmes, and Curtis Fisher-Oschlager. Thank you very much. We close our concert this afternoon with three movements from Verdi's Requiem Mass.
Woo!